Thank you for joining us today. My name is Ryan Lathan. I am the manager of marketing and communications at Fort Worth Opera. Woo-hoo.
Yeah!
Welcome to the third weekend of internationally renowned soprano Jennifer Rowley's six-week virtual audition intensive.
Yay! Yeah!
Today, we are super excited to kick off the first live audition panel with Heart So Happy, Metropolitan Opera soprano Angel Blue, beloved artist manager Peter Randsman, president of Randsman Artists Management, and Fort Worth Opera's amazing artistic director, composer, and conductor Joe Illick.
Hey.
Yes, hey. Welcome everyone.
So a little about these amazing individuals. In 2009, soprano Angel Blue won the Sarzuela Prize and second prize in Operalia and has since skyrocketed to global fame with her stunning voice and warm, magnetic stage presence. She has sung on the stages of the world's leading opera houses, including La Scala, Frankfurt Opera, San Francisco Opera, and New York Metropolitan Opera, where she has continued to receive rave reviews since her debut as Mimi in Puccini's La Boheme, all the way to this season's riveting performance as Bess in the Gershwin's Porgy and Bess. Angel, it is a gift to have you with us here today.
Thank you so much for having me. I'm very honored to be here with you today.
Thank you for being with us, sweetheart.
For over three decades, Peter Randsman and Randsman Artist Management have fostered the growth and been responsible for the distinguished careers of over 50 globally successful opera singers who have performed at top houses such as Wiener Staatsoper and the Met. In his pre-artist management career, he was a gifted bass with Broadway credits and national tour.
I want to listen to this his belt.
And he appeared in the film Brighton Beach with Ruth Gordon. I'm so envious. Harold and Maude is my favorite movie. I love her. And Lee Strasberg. Once upon a time, I participated in one of his brilliant masterclasses, so this is really, truly a full circle treat for me. Thank you for being here with us today, Peter.
Thank you. I'm so excited to be here today.
We are too.
Thank you, Peter. Yeah.
Thank you.
And finally, Joe Illick, who is my artistic director here at Fort Worth Opera, has served for 15 seasons as music director and principal conductor for our company, until he became our artistic director. From 2007 to 2017, he was the executive and artistic director of Performance Santa Fe. He has conducted for Opera Theater St. Louis, San Francisco Opera Marilla, and the Covent Garden Ensemble, and many, many other companies throughout the United States and Europe. He is the composer of the family opera Stone Soup, which we will be premiering next month, and Frida Kahlo and The Bravest Girl in the World, both of whom were created with the wonderful lyricist Mark Campbell. He is also the composer of the monodrama Emma, which was performed on public television, Feel the Tango. We always have to give a nod to the librettists here. So librettist Susan Westfall, and Santa Fe Opera's Unshakable with librettist Andrea Fellows Walters, and many other incredible works. I love you, Joe. I'm so happy you're here. So yay.
Thank you so much, it's great.
Yeah, thank you for being here.
And congrats to our 12 wonderful singers today. I pass the baton over to you, DJ Lorelli.
Oh, thank you so much, Ryan. Thank you, Angel, Peter, Joe, for being here for our very first virtual audition panel. I'm so excited. I cannot wait to hear these incredible 12 singers. Let me just tell everybody who's in the Zoom with us and welcome. Thank you everyone for being here. Let me just tell you the format, what we're gonna do today, and welcome to everyone on Facebook as well. Each singer will enter the waiting room as if they are entering a real audition room. So they're gonna hang out in the waiting room and wait until it's their time. They're gonna enter into the Zoom at their audition time, and they're gonna begin their audition. We're gonna be asking them what their tech is, like last week when we had Elorin Meeker with us, who was amazing again. We're going to be asking them what their tech is so we can kind of even the playing field for everybody. So we'll know if somebody's using an external mic or if they're just on their iPhone. We want to make sure that everybody's treated equally as far as sound and video is concerned out in the world. And all of the competitions are going to also be asking what your tech is. So we're going to ask it as well. Then they're going to sing their first piece. We're going to ask them what their repertoire list is. And then they're going to sing part of probably a second piece. Then we're going to give them feedback on their audition. Then they're going to leave as if they were in a real audition and leaving the room. They'll probably come back and join us, but that's the format for today's virtual audition panel. I'm so nervous and excited. This is so great. So please, everyone, if somehow you become unmuted, please, please, please watch that you stay muted, especially while people are singing. Something happened last week where we had someone unmute during somebody singing, and I just want to make sure that doesn't happen today. So please, please use the chat, chat it up. You know I love it, so keep it going, but please, please keep yourself unmuted. Joe, while he is here, I just want to give a very heartfelt and personal thank you to you and to Fort Worth Opera, not only for having me, but for making this class and all of the classes free to everyone. None of these singers are paying to sing today. No one in the Zoom or on Facebook is paying, and we appreciate you. Yes, thank you, Joe. We appreciate you and the company so much for this. This has been, I know everyone has enjoyed everything, and I just want to thank you for continuing to make this free for everyone. And in saying that, we have been able to keep this going because of all of your very generous donations. So thank you to all of you here on Zoom and on Facebook. Please continue those donations. We appreciate you so much. We can continue to bring you this great content with your donations, and we can continue to keep it free, which we know everybody wants. So Joe, thank you for making that happen. Everyone else, thank you.
I just want to say, you've been so inspiring, and this whole series, more and more people watch it every single week. It's fantastic. And we're all gonna stick through this awful thing together, right?
We are. And we're gonna train the next generation to be ready when it's done, yes?
Yes.
That said, I think it's time to let in our first singer. Ryan, can you let in Erica Simmons from the waiting room?
Sure.
Here we go, the first singer. I'm so excited and nervous. I love it. Is she back? I hope she's back. Erica is not here. Where did she go? All right, we're gonna move along then. Why don't we let in Madison? Is she here?
Yes, on the bottom. Yeah.
On the bottom. Erica Simmons,
she's muted.
She's muted. And let's unmute her. Unmute her. Here she is.
It wouldn't allow me to unmute myself.
Oh, I'm sorry, sweetheart. Welcome, welcome. Thank you, Erica, for being with us today.
Thank you for having me.
Can you please tell us what tech you're using for your audition today?
Yes, I'm using my Dell laptop with a Yeti external mic. And
wonderful.
And I have a Lumen LED light and Ethernet cord.
Oh, Ethernet, perfect. Thank you so much for that. That's awesome. Okay, Erica, please announce your first piece and we will get started.
I will begin with the Chardash.
Wonderful.
Thank you.
Great, thank you so much.
Beautiful.
Can you tell us what the rest of your repertoire list is?
I've also prepared Depuis le Jour from Charpentier's Louise, Mikayla Sager from Puccini's La Bohème, Come Scoglio from Mozart's Così fa niente, and My Man's Gone Now from Gershwin's Porgy and Bess.
Okay, great. I'm going to throw this directly over to the beautiful Angel Blue and let you choose her second selection, hun.
Erica, hello. Hi. Just because I'm partial, I would love to hear Depuis le Jour.
Sure.
Fabulous.
Thank you.
Thank you so much, Erica. Oh. Thank you. I just want to thank you first for being the very first singer of these virtual audition panels. You did a great job. Fantastic. I'm going to go to Joe first and pass the mic over to you for some feedback.
Erica, you have such a beautiful, opulent voice. It's gorgeous. Obviously, I know you. I've heard you before. I know you have this wonderful voice. And you look great. I don't know about cameras and tech and stuff. Peter and I represent the antediluvian generation in this whole thing. So, you know, but it seemed like your camera was sort of shooting you from the floor up. So instead of seeing your beautiful face straight on, we were kind of looking up at you. And I don't know if that's something that's within your power to change when you do these online things. Just real quick, I would say my very favorite moments were when you got on a note and you felt so happy that you just melted and you played around and you felt the freedom to do that. Like when you went, je suis heureux, and when you went, je crois rêver, you know, that high A, and before that, that high F sharp. But there are other times when those same notes happened that you felt more pressured somehow. Not that you weren't able to do whatever you wanted, but you didn't choose to. And I think whether it's something really sensual and slow-ish like Depuis le Jour or something like the second part of the Chardash, you have the technical ability to always take the time to do those things. And in our fast world, you know, everybody wants to just stop and listen to beauty. So do it. Just indulge us. And the more you do it, the more people will want to listen, the more people will want to hire you.
Bravo. I love that. Thank you, Joe. Wonderful. Peter, how about you next?
Hi there. Erica, what a beautiful voice. And I agree with what Joe said, that opulence, the beautiful richness, but also the generosity of spirit when you sing, which comes through. This is the beauty of our new normal. And this is coming through. I also want to applaud your trills. Trilling is a lost art. And I have to say, your trills were stunning and accurate. Now, one thing we all know, and that is at auditions, no matter what kind of audition it is, our breath and the nerves get the better of us. Therefore, when you feel that adrenaline, invite that adrenaline in instead of fighting that adrenaline. By fighting the adrenaline, your breath goes high. Because I like to see you sing to the ends of phrases. This is something I'm constantly saying. And because of the nerves and the breath going high, I saw you, I think I know what Joe was talking about, not being able to continue through and sustain to the end of a note or the end of a phrase, where I know that you have the ability to do it because you showed it to us in these other exquisite moments. And I really believe it's just getting under your breath and doing what you need to do to make sure the adrenaline works with you rather than against you. But I applaud you. That's just exquisite singing.
Beautiful. Fabulous, Peter. Thank you. And Angel.
Yes. Erica, I love you. I love your voice. I think you're so beautiful. Thank you for singing both of those arias so well and with so much heart. You know, for us singers, we're not in... we are in our element because we get to sing, but all of this technological stuff is just new. It's brand spanking new for me. I know it is for all of us, I believe. I want to encourage you again, like what Joe said in the beginning about the positioning of your camera. Mm-hmm. It's very important for singers to know that we need to be seen. I always would say, I'll say from the waist up is the most important thing. And for the camera to be almost as, I don't know if it's so much the way this camera is set, but really straight on so that you can be seen well. Another thing is lighting. So I would encourage you, if you're able to, I would encourage you to get some lights, or I know there's a ring light that people are using. And if you have, do you have a stand that you can put the camera on? Okay.
Challenging.
Well,
yes, girl.
I totally understand you. So let me tell you what I have in my house that works for me. I'm 5'11", so I totally understand the struggle. It is real. If you have any kind of Amazon boxes, this goes for every singer. If you have any kind of boxes, just stack them up on top of each other. I have about right now about 4 boxes because I'm tall. So I would encourage you to do that. I love your repertoire. I agree with everything that Peter and Joe said, but my thing is more of the virtual aspect of it. And that is definitely make sure, like right now, you're very well lit and it would be great to have that kind of lighting when you're singing. But bravo to you, Erica. Much love to you. Keep singing. Beautiful.
Thank you so much, everyone. Thank you. Erica, I completely agree. I think you're fantastic. I love your look. I love your dress. You look fantastic today. I agree with what everyone else said. We need to move that camera higher. So another way that you can do that is if you have a music stand in your house, just lift that thing up and put your computer right on the top of it and sort of allow that to bring our eye up. I want to see those beautiful eyes. And I was kind of missing them because the camera was too low. So if that's the lesson you learned today, awesome. the Salazar brothers, when they were on 2 weeks ago, they talked about the lighting as well. And there are some very inexpensive, what they call box lights, that you could just get one on Amazon for like $35 and have that in the house. And that would just illuminate your face even more, because I really do want to see those amazing eyes. So, but really the rep is fantastic. The voice is fantastic. The only technical thing that I heard was that the coloratura in the chardosh was just a little bit off with your track. So I don't know if you want to get the track a little bit slower so you can really keep that nice and clean, or if you want to just work on getting that coloratura a little bit faster and a little bit cleaner. Either way is totally great, but make sure you clean up that coloratura in the second half of the chardash, just so that you're consistently with that track. Because people, it throws the ear off when something goes, oh wait, that's not quite there. So that's, I mean, a really wonderful audition. Thank you so much for being with us. And we will move on to our next singers. Thank you so much, Erica. Thank you. Okay, next we have Madison Marie McIntosh. Madison, is she in from the waiting room? Can we turn her video on and unmute her?
Hey, Madison.
Madison, is she here? I hear her, I think.
She's there.
She is here.
Okay, wonderful. Hi, Madison. Thank you so much for being with us today. Can you please tell us? Thank you so much, honey. Please tell us what tech you're using today.
I'm using Zoom as a sound on an iPad.
Wonderful. Okay, great. Thank you so much. Please let us know what you'd like to sing first, and we'll get started.
I'd like to sing Una Voce Poco Fa.
Oh!
brava. Thank you so much, Madison. Can you tell us what the rest of your repertoire list is?
I have Ti tanti palpiti, la scena of Ti tanti palpiti. Un'altra volta ancora from Partenope by Handel. There is a garden from Trouble in Tahiti, the Seguidilla, and by Kinsel from Der Evangeliman, or Schöne Jugendtage.
Okay. Can you also tell us who your live pianist is? Because it's so great to have a live pianist.
He's Gregory Ritchie. Thank you very much, Greg.
Greg Ritchie, thank you so much for being with us today. I'm going to throw this one to Joe. Joe, would you like to pick Madison's second piece or portion of second piece?
Yeah, I would say let's do There Is a Garden, but just the second time round, second verse.
Wonderful.
Sure. So maybe from Then I Ran to Find the Singer.
Then I Ran, yep.
Wonderful, Madison. Thank you so much. Beautiful. Let's go to Angel first this time.
Bravo, Madison.
Thank you.
Lovely. I love your repertoire. I think the one thing that jumped out at me was just the fact that you're standing. I can see your whole body, which is great, but I think you might be a little bit too far back. And of course, that's just a preference thing. I mean, I think for myself, I really just want to see from the waist up. And I think you have, you're very expressive when you sing, which is lovely. And so don't be afraid to show that in the camera, just a bit closer. The other thing I wanted to suggest was you have lovely dynamics. Use them a bit more, I think, because for all of us at this time, being able to sing with a microphone is actually a big luxury, because I know Jennifer's just laughing, that's true. Don't you think so, Jennifer?
At this time,
it's like, you know, the soft singing can really be soft, and the loud singing actually doesn't have to be as quite as strong or quite as loud. So those are just my two suggestions, but bravo to you, wonderful.
Thank you, Angel. How about Peter next?
How are you, Madison?
Very well, thank you. How are you, Peter?
Great to see you. I'm just so impressed with each time I hear you. Obviously, I know Madison, and Each time I hear you, there's so many beautiful changes. You are an elegant and classy singer. When you sing, what gets me is, and this is important for anyone that's auditioning, most importantly, is the first few notes you sing are what gets the listener in terms of, am I interested in this voice or am I not? And as soon as you opened up your mouth, there was like a spark in your sound, in your eye, in your being, and you made us sit up and listen. You command as an artist and as a singer, you command us to be a participant and to listen happily. I love the way you sing coloratura, and I love that not only do you have a beautiful and generous chest voice, but you can sing B naturals, and your runs are clean and fun to listen to. With the second piece, what I want a little more of is a little more sense of, and I agree with you, Angel, I know exactly what you're saying. I want a little more of a resign and a little more of majesty and nobility, which means a little less is more. And that's what I hear as well. But I do have to say, I'm so thrilled with every time that I hear you. It just gets more and more exciting. It's a really, really classy thing that you do when you present to us. Thank you.
Wonderful. Thank you, Peter. And on to Joe.
Yeah, I love that. I got the opportunity to hear you, Madison, because you did a phone audition with me. And it was so great because you were in that same space and you were singing Una Voce Poco Fa, and the quality, actually I was playing for you on the other end. So this is much nicer for me to be here. The thing I think that everybody says is you have this marvelous rich voice and you're so confident that you're able to take time when you want to. And the thing that Angel and Peter both alluded to is so true. If even not in COVID times and not in virtual times, I think all of us hesitate to take the courage to sing really softly and take time and more than we believe is okay. But if one silver lining of COVID is that it trains us all to make people focus in on us and take time, that's worth it, I think. Anyway, beautiful. And I agree that this character of Dinah somehow is beaten down. And however you know how to make that come across, it's probably a way of thinking about a person who, unlike you, doesn't really have a moment of joy in their daily life. I mean, you exude joy, and just keep that. That's so fantastic. And I know you wrote those cadenzas yourself in the Una Voce Poco Fa. Is that fabulous or what?
Great. They're wonderful. They're original. Awesome.
Yes, they are. Absolutely. I just want to add one last thing before we let Madison go. We heard Madison earlier in our first series of masterclasses. On our young artist class with Scott Kuzliak. And Madison also sang Una Voce for that. And I have to say, the amount of growth that has happened with you and that aria since that class, wow, wow, wow. It sounds spectacular. I love the high notes that you have added in. I love the grounded sound that you're getting. And I love that sassy character. It's fantastic. You've really gone there with it. And it really, like Peter said, does make an amazing first impression. You grab us right from moment one. And so I really, really applaud you for doing the same aria and showing us such immense growth with it. So really, bravissima, Madison. Fantastic job.
That's very helpful to me. I really think that's helped me to start to reach the next level. So thank you.
Fabulous. Bravissima, Madison. Thank you. Thank you. Okay, we're going to move on to Miss Audre Hurley. Audre, is she in the waiting room or is she in with us already?
She is in with us already, and I'm going to unmute
her. Okay. Fabulous. Audre. Hi, Audre. Thank you so much for being with us today. Can you talk us through your tech first?
Yes, I'm running an Ethernet cable through my iPad, and I have an external speaker for the audio.
Wonderful, great, thank you so much. Okay, please announce your first piece and we will get started.
Okay, thank you. My name is Audre Hurley and I will be starting with Pace, Pace mio Dio from Verdi's La Forza del Destino.
All right.
Oh,
Thank you so much. Thank you. Can you tell us what the rest of your repertoire list is?
Yes, I also have Du bist der Lenz, Dich ter Halle, Porgi Amor, and Visi d'Arte.
Okay, how about Peter this time? You could choose the second piece.
Thank you. Du bist der Lenz, please.
Nice.
Thank you.
Since he got to choose that, and I was very happy that he chose that.
You were rocking out to that. I saw you.
I love it. Yeah.
You know, as soon as I heard you start singing within about a minute, I kept thinking, Wagner, Strauss, Eileen Farrell. I hope she listens to a lot of Eileen Farrell. Okay, but here's what I have to say. I hear you and your voice, which is a fantastic and a rare instrument. It's a young lyrical spinto that I believe will find its home in Wagner, Strauss, Janacek, and Tchaikovsky. And with all of that, all those great ladies, Leighton Price, Gwyneth Jones, Leonie Riesnick, Regine Crespin, they all sang Verdi and Puccini and Verismo. Having said that, please be cautious with Pace. Go and listen to Leontyn Price sing it. Go and listen to Zinka Milanoff. When you sing the first Pace, it can't be quadruple forte. Start at a teeny weeny 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 little hairline piano, and slowly, as you sustain it with high energy, open it up to 110% and then taper it back. Listen to Zinka, listen to Leontyn. They'll teach you. I'm not asking you to imitate them. And I need you to please be more expressive in the Italian. Alvaro, io t'amo. Because some of what you were doing with the diction in the Italian was monochromatic, and you lose your audience because it all sounds the same. And just like Angel had said earlier, and I thank you for this, Angel, it's important, no matter what you're singing, to mix it up and have plenty of fortissimo, but plenty of piano singing, because piano singing, even with the intimacy, again, like what I said earlier, demands your audience be there. But please, please, Wagner, Strauss, Janacek, Eileen Farrell, Kirsten Flockstead, Nilsson Jones, all the greats, listen to them, don't copy them. This is a rare voice.
Yes, I agree with you.
Thank you.
Angel, how about you?
Well, I agree 100% with Peter. I can tell you now, I'm probably going to agree this whole time with Peter and Joe. I love what you're saying. I'm actually taking notes myself. Thank you. Audrey, oh, great. I mean, I love it. I love your voice. I just want to encourage you that I know that when we go into auditions, we get so nervous. It's just a part of what we do. But as best as you can, you know, all of you ladies so far have had just these wonderful voices. And I think, of course, we'll have more beautiful voices throughout the afternoon. But I want to encourage you to sing in your breath, constantly be in your body. And I'm not suggesting that you weren't, but I just want you to always sort of check in with that as you go through your auditions, as you're singing. Constantly just come back to, okay, how am I feeling? Where am I? And with that, I think you'll find more expression. With that, you'll also find more comfort in just in your singing. I love your setup though. I think you're well lit. I like where you're standing. I love your dress. It's wonderful. So just keep going like you are. Brava to you.
Yeah. Joe, over to you.
So the first thing I wrote when you started to sing is, wow. I mean, we all are sitting here loving your voice. But I'll tell you the thing that happens when you deliver a voice like that, everybody wants you to deliver something else too. And after a few seconds, it's like, damn, that's such a fabulous voice. Now, come on. And I think there are two things that may be working in your brain and the Leonora. One is that because she is miserable, you're trying to convey misery with every single phrase you sing. And I think that's not a smart idea. I think that, you know, this whole style of music is passionate and the dramatic impulses, you know, Verdi brings half of them, and maybe psychologically it sounds like it's already happening to you, but I think you have to bring the other half. And as we all know, I'm not a singer, but having loved singers all my life, I just feel like if you explore how much letting that dramatic impulse affect your voice instead of you trying to push down too much drama so that it doesn't hurt your beautiful voice, you'll figure out what things work and what things don't. But I think as we listen to Pace Pace, not just the first note that Peter was so wonderfully eloquent about, but lots of times throughout the whole piece, we want, you know, to you to explore the full range of emotions that the human voice can do, which is of course everything. Du bist Lenz, you were happy. That was so cool to watch you transform, and wonderful. But you know, yes, Wagner and Strauss and Janáček, but yes, Verdi too. Just get yourself in there and see if your voice can take it. And I know it can when the drama actually affects and leads your voice.
Absolutely. Thank you so much, Joe. Yeah, Audrey, I 100% agree. I might actually flip-flop for some auditions and start with that Du bist Lenz, because you seem more comfortable in your body and the voice seems more settled in that piece. Maybe it's older, maybe it's because it's shorter, I'm not sure. But to me, that is a very strong start. And then we can ask for Tosca or Pace Pace or the Pur Jamor or whatever those things, and you give us more chance to hear maybe more things. For me, the Pace Pace is very good, but I agree 1,000,000% with everyone what everyone else has said. Specifically, Peter, I literally wrote first note, mezzo di voce, gotta make it happen, exactly the same as you, exactly the same. And you really do have to start that first note in nothing. I mean, really nothing. And then deepen that vowel. And then bring it back to nothing before you come back down for the che. It's a moment. It stops the world, that moment. And you need that. So the amazing women that Peter suggested, please listen, because really seriously, the Verdi style, like he said, is all about that passion. It's all about that connection. And what Angel said about the breath as well, 100%. I didn't feel it at all in the Wagner. I didn't feel at all that we weren't on the body or on the breath, but I felt it in the Verdi. So maybe until you get a little bit deeper and more comfortable with that Verdi, you should start with the Wagner and really get, you know, give us a really strong first impression.
But just to encourage you,
Audre, just so you don't feel like we're saying don't sing the Verdi, we are not.
No, sing the Verdi. Sing the Verdi.
Toward the end, toward the end,
sure.
When you went dwall, you know, there's that G flat up there. That was fantastic. That's your keynote for what you can derive the way you sing other parts of it for.
Agreed.
Move the mezzo-soprano part faster when the triplets come. Verdi doesn't write it, but we all know he wants it to go faster. Go faster.
Totally agree, Joe. All I'm saying is for Audre to make the best first impression that she can right now in audition season. You know, maybe flip-flop them until the Verdi is a little bit more in the body and then flip-flop them back. But Audre, it's an amazing voice. It's a special, special voice. The top is incredible. Bravissima. Fantastic. Thank you so much for being with us today. Thank you, honey.
Thank you.
Okay, we are going to move on to Elizebeth Barnes. Is Elizabeth with us in the waiting room or in the meeting here?
She is here with us. I'm muting.
All righty, here we go.
This is so wonderful. This is so
great singing, right?
Yeah.
Yes. Fun and great singing.
Yes.
Elizabeth, are you there?
This too. Oh,
she was in the waiting room a few minutes ago. I saw.
There she is. She's there.
Okay. Hi, Elizabeth. Can you hear us? No, she can't. We might have a tech problem. Let's see.
Hello.
Elizabeth.
Hello. Hello.
She can hear you, but she can't respond. She's on. So yeah. It must be a tech problem that
now she's got a 10 or 20 happen. On screen.
We got to get the husband involved. So we got, I love it. I love when we have the helpers. The helpers are awesome.
Yeah, that's fun.
Talk again, honey. Okay, let's unmute her one more time because she's muted again. No, we don't have you. We don't have you, Elizabeth. Sorry. Oh,
what about now?
Yes. We got you.
There you are.
Fabulous.
A whole external microphone situation, but I just unplugged it, so I'm just going to use the natural.
No worries. Let's do it. No problem whatsoever. So we're not in the external mic then. What do we got going on now?
MacBook Air speakers. We'll
wonderful. Thank you so much. Just announce your first piece for us and we'll get going.
Wonderful. I'm very excited to sing Cœur sans amour from Cendrillon.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Wow, thank you. Thank you so much. Can you tell us the rest of your repertoire list?
Absolutely. I have This Journey from Dead Man Walking, Wie du warst from Der Rosenkavalier, Zmanje Implacabili from Così fan tutte, and Sein wir wieder gut from Ariadne auf Naxos.
Okay, let's go to Joe. How about you pick the second piece?
Oh, would you just sing the composer, please, Elizabeth?
Yes.
Yes. We all wanted the same thing. Mic were you going to use?
So I had a stereo setup and it was supposed to go into a Scarlett box that then
okay
I tested it earlier, everything was fine, but
and then it happens. But just so you know, we still can hear the full wonderful beautiful sound of your voice, the richness. The only thing that happens is the high notes are overblowing the mic, but since we know that you didn't have the external mic on, we can take that out of the equation. So just to kind of put you a little bit at ease, if that happens in an audition to you, unplug that thing and go with what you have, because we still get a really wonderful idea of what your voice is, how big your voice is, the color, and all of that stuff. So don't even worry about any of that technical stuff if that happens again. Joe, let's go to you. Since you picked the second piece, you can start.
I have to do full disclosure. I got a little teary because I heard Elizabeth when she was 14 singing a Schumann song. And wow, have you changed? Just, you know, every few years I hear you and it's just magnificent what happens. So I'm going to talk for 1 second about why a composer might write a male part for a female voice, because you did two trouser parts.
Right.
And I think it is not what some people think, that somehow when you play a male part, you have to cut off emotion the way it seems to women that men always do. And that may or may not be true. But what the composer wants is a role that they won't entrust to a male person, because they know that only a female voice can bring the sensitivity and the passion to it that that role needs. So
don't dampen the emotions in these characters, especially the Prince Charming. Right. If you're gonna start with that because, you know, he's whiny and moany most of the time, own it and sell it. You know, don't just show that you sound gorgeous, which you do, and that you know everything and that you have great friendship, blah, blah, blah. Who cares, right? We wanna see that character and we wanna see his misery so that when things get a whole lot better in a few minutes, we're so glad for him. But it's wonderful. I just think too, in the composer, even although it's naturally written into the music that you have to be more exuberant, you can still go way more. And when there's that moment of declaring what music is to a composer and to Richard Strauss for that matter, you know, you just take time for that magic. What is it? Oh, well, it's the greatest thing humanity ever invented. You know, take your time and do it. Do it all the way. But wonderful, wonderful. So great to hear you. Congratulations. Great.
Thank you so much.
Thank you, Joe. That's great. Angel, how about over to you?
Okay. I loved that, Elizabeth. First of all, bravo to you for not being stressed out by the microphone. Because before auditions, if anything goes wrong for me, I get really stressed. So you didn't seem stressed at all. So bravo to you for that and for your lovely singing as well. I'm only gonna talk about virtual stuff that I see. So the first thing I wanna suggest is if this happens to you in an audition where your external microphone does not work, find out where your computer settings are for your audio. And when I've written all this down, so I'm just gonna try to go through this quickly. The first thing I would suggest to do is when you get into your settings, you're going to want to turn down the gain or the input on your computer settings. If you are using a phone, then do the same on your phone. You wanna check that mic sensitivity. On a Mac computer, I do know that they actually have the, I can't think of the name, the bar that shows just how high or low the sensitivity will be. So if that does happen in an audition, find out, just play around with your computer one day and see where all of those settings are for your audio so that you can do that really quickly. Because of course, you know, as opera singers, when we go up high, it becomes distorted because the mics can't handle how strong our voices are. So that's one thing. The second thing I wanted to share with you is the type of mic that you can get. There's a Blue Yeti microphone. I think most people probably know all of this. There's also the HyperX Quadcast microphone. I use a microphone that is a USB-C connect, and that these are just things that you can go to if this happens in an audition that you can just do really quickly. One other thing that I'd like to suggest to you is your background. Are you tall? You seem tall.
I'm 5'6".
Awesome. Okay, that's tall. That's good.
I'm in a dungeon though. So
okay.
My ceiling is very low.
Okay, great. Well, I just want to suggest maybe if you want, you know, I'm a flowery kind of girl, so I like to have stuff in the background. You're the only singer that I've noticed that doesn't, I think Erica also had a white background. It might just be a nice idea to have something for them to, I mean, of course we want to look at you, but it might just be a nice idea also to have something in the background, a flower, something, anything that sort of brings sort of like an emotion to the room. I like a lot of yellow and stuff like that because yellow brings good energy. That's just me. But something like that I think would be helpful when we're watching you. The cord in the background drove me totally crazy. That's just because of what I saw. And no problem. This is, you know, that
I love it.
Awesome. I love it. But bravo to you. Bravo, lovely.
Thank you.
Over to Peter.
Hi there. How are you?
Wonderful. Thank you.
It was great to hear you. I absolutely love your voice. And having said that, let's admit that the composer is the pinnacle for high lyric mezzo. Let's be real, let's be honest. It was written for a soprano by Strauss. Lotta Lehmann sang it. And my first composer was Evelyn Lear at the Met. So up until the late 70s, sopranos sang it. So you have to take this piece and sing it, I believe, from the top down. You were singing it from the bottom up and weighing down all of your climactic moments. The first B flat you backed off of instead of singing into, and the final B flat, I believe that if you would stop, disconnect, take a breath, and then sing the final B flat, that'll work better for you. And the music will even be better for you because you don't ever want to get that feeling that a singer is running out of breath. But I just think it's important. Also, singers, it's important to know when you have to sing the same phrase over and over again, or the same word, yadach, 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 you're building. And when you speak naturally to somebody, if you're going to use the same word 8 times, you have to start at a certain level and build and build and build and build, which you did not do, which I understand, but we're here to throw out ideas to give you inspiration to try to make some of these changes next time. Do take that breath before that final B flat, and take a bigger breath before the first B flat. It's all about breath. I'm not a voice teacher, but I'm just saying to you, I hear this and I know this, and I'm crazy about your voice. You are a classy singer, and you're also an expressive singer, but you can also be expressive and find less than less is more moments, okay?
Great.
And that's all about the breath, and that has to do with nerves and has to do with dealing with your adrenaline. Okay, sorry.
Bravo, Peter. This is why you're my favorite judging buddy. Because
I love you.
We literally have the same brain.
You and I always look at each other and go, yes.
Yes, yes. No, I was going to tell her exactly the same thing. Stop and take that breath so we get that like the biggest musique ever. Take the breath. You have full permission to do it. The orchestra's not going on without you. Well, maybe that track's going on without you, then forget about it. But when we're back to a live pianist and all of those kinds of things, put in that breath, relax that larynx, anchor that body, get that thing ready to go, and then let it rip. Yeah, I totally agree with you, Peter. Bravo, bravo, bravissima. Thank you so much, Elizabeth. Your voice is spectacular.
Thank you. Really
fantastic. Okay, let's move on to Miss Molly Dunn. Is Molly with us? Here she is. I'm going to admit, we're mid-midding. Molly and unmuting. Yes, yes, Molly.
Hi,
Molly. How you doing, hon? Thanks for being with us.
I'm great. How are you?
Good. Thank you. Can you tell us what tech you're using today?
Oh, yes. Okay. So I'm using a Zoom H6 microphone. Okay. I have a ring light. I have an umbrella light. And I think my iPad.
And you look fantastic. So let us know what your first piece will be and we can get started.
Okay. I'd love to sing for you Dis-moi que je suis belle from Thaïs.
Great.
Thank you.
Can you tell us the rest of your repertoire? Oh, she her earphone.
I'm sorry.
That's okay. I forgot about the earphones. Thank you so much. Can you tell us the rest of the repertoire list?
Yes. I have Ain't It a Pretty Night from Susanna, Marietta's Lied from Die Tote Stadt, Donde Lieta Uschi from La Boheme, and Emily's Goodbye Aria from Our Town.
I'm going to go to Peter on this one and let you pick.
Donde Lieta, please.
Of course.
Thank you.
Okay. Also, I realized like 3 seconds in my original sound was it on. Should I have stopped
in
the real?
No, it's fine.
Okay.
It's fine. It's going in and out a little bit, but we're not losing any high notes or anything like that, so.
Okay.
Thank you.
have a, I'm gonna let her get her earphones. Brava, Molly. Thank you so much. Do you have your earphones on?
Thank you.
Okay, there she is. Yes. Good. Thank you so much, Molly. Let's go to Peter first.
Okay, there was a reason that I asked for Don Delieta after the first piece, and I think you know what it is. I believe that Thais is what I call, first of all, hello.
Hi.
Great to hear you, and you know that I love your voice. Your voice is absolutely beautiful. It's clean, it's clear, it's got a tear in it. Like I call, there are voices that have a little bit of a tear, a little bit of sadness in it. There's a vulnerability in it, and that's what I love about your sound. But I believe there are certain arias that artists work on that are for the studio. I want you to keep working on the Thais. I don't think it does you any good right now. I'm only talking about now, staying pragmatic, to be offering that either in competitions or in auditions. It's a very heavy role, even though it's a high role, and it causes singers, when they're nervous, to oversing consistently. And in your passaggio, be aware of your passaggio. A lot of the G's and F sharps were flat. I want singers to start recording themselves more and listening, not saying, hey, I sound good. We know you're talented. We believe in your talent. Sit down and go, I didn't realize that F sharp was a little under. That G, my passaggio, the G is really under. You can fix it. Call your voice teacher. Make a voice lesson. The me is who you are. It was exquisite artistically. I believe I got more about who you were vocally as an artist completely from the short Puccini piece rather than the longer Massenet piece, which is not to say that I don't think you should continue working on the Thais, but be aware of your pitch because you have a way of singing that you've chosen to sort of sneak up on the pitches. Be careful that you're not sneaking up from too far below because you do eventually get there. Listen to recordings of yourself. I think you are an exquisite singer. I think you're a special kind of an artist and I just love your sound. I love your whole artistry. Thank you.
Thank you so much.
Angel, how about you?
Molly, I love that. I loved both pieces. I agree with Peter. I think Thais is pretty heavy. But I love the way you sang it. I would like to suggest that before I say anything about Don Delieta, I love your setup. And I think that how you have your lights is lovely. You look beautiful. And I like your dress also. You present yourself very well. I want to suggest that maybe in the Don Delieta, when you start out that very first phrase, I think it's a bit more simple than what you made it. That's just my opinion. I think that as Mimi, because you know she just had this really big dramatic scene with Marcello, and now this is I think more simple than what you just sang. You know, you can play around with it and try different ways and whatever you are most comfortable with and whatever the conductor lets you do, then you know that is of course how you move forward with that. I want to suggest also in keeping with tone and staying on pitch, I find that emotion really helps me to find the pitches. I know that might sound weird. I don't know if I'm expressing that well, but I find that if I have an emotion behind every single word that I'm saying, every single, especially with Mimi, because I've sung that role so many times, when I'm really connected with her as a character, she's quite simple, but she's a still water that runs very deep. And I find that when I'm connected with her incredibly, very strong emotionally, I usually don't have any issues with the pitch. As sopranos, that's our passaggio, as Peter said. And that's one part where all of us have to be very careful. So I want to encourage you to find the simplicity of Mimi, that thing that makes her so special as a person. Find that for yourself, and with that, connect to her emotionally. And I think all of the things about her character will fall into place as you study that a bit more, if that makes sense. I hope it does. But I love your Don Delieta, and you're gonna be, if you haven't already sung it, you will be a fantastic Mimi. Congratulations to you.
Thank you so much.
Yo, over to you.
Wonderful. You're a communicator. You love to get yourself across to us, and we all feel it, and we love it. The paradox is if you try too hard to communicate, you communicate less. Mm-hmm. So it's finding, I think, the right balance, which isn't the same all the time. It's probably different in everything, where you can start somewhere and give us the illusion, at least, that you're gradually finding your way into the big message that you're delivering. Because if you deliver the big message in the first four bars, the rest of it is just, you know, superfluous. So when the Thais started, I thought it almost sounded like you were pulling down on your voice. And again, because I think you were trying to show us the entire emotion of the entire arc of the piece, of the whole opera, which is more information than we want in the first sentence of Dis-moi que je suis belle. But fabulous. I mean, you know that you have a lot to give, and you have it all. I think the paradox, like I say, is figuring out how to calm yourself down so that you give it to your audience in stages and tell them the story emotionally of what builds up for you, rather than try to give us everything all the time.
Absolutely. Thank you so much, Joe. Molly, absolutely stunning. Beautiful. Wonderful. Thank you so much.
Thank you, everyone.
And you look beautiful. Love the setup. It does look fantastic. All right, let's move on to our baritone today. Andres Cascante. Are you there, Andres? Do we have him? Andres.
Hello.
Hello. Thank you so much for being with us today. There he is.
Of course.
Oh, and do I see Melanie over there too? Yeah, hi, sure. Melanie. Hi. Melanie will be on with us next week, right? Yes, next week. Thank you so much, guys, for being with us. What's your tech that you've got going on today, Andres?
Yes, okay. I have an Acer laptop. I have a Blues Noble mic, and I'm singing 6 feet away from it in good coronavirus pandemic fashion. and also, I have a ring light and a couple of lights around the room just to like avoid having shadows.
Fantastic. Thank you so much. Please let us know what your first piece is and we will get started.
Of course. I would like to sing L'Orage s'est calmé from the Pearl Fishers.
C'est impossible, je fais ton so terrible. Don't you not be to hear the fall.
Great. Thank you so much, Andres. Can you tell us what the rest of the repertoire list is?
Of course. I have Hai già vinta la causa from Le nozze di Figaro. I have A per sempre from I Puritani, Mi aldea from Los Gavilanes, Nel mondo e nell'abisso from Tamerlano by Handel.
Let's go to Angel for this one.
Ooh, I would like to hear the count, but is it okay if I ask Joe and Peter, do you also agree with that?
Yeah.
Yes, that was my choice.
Oh, good, okay.
Wonderful. yes, let's hear it. Thank you.